So anyone that knows me knows that I love the movie La La Land. I love the jazz music. I love the realness of it. I love the awkwardness of the characters. Among all the reasons, I love this idea of pursuing what you're passionate about. The story follows these two characters, Mia and Seb. Sebastian is this jazz pianist and is trying to get his own club up and running. And Mia is this up-and-coming actress that is pursuing the life of an actress. On my second time watching the movie, I noticed something really interesting during a conversation that Mia and Seb have at the Lighthouse Jazz Club. Mia tells Seb, "I don't really like jazz," and Seb can't have that, so he kind of takes her to this jazz club. They're listening, they're watching, and Seb is explaining very passionately about why this is so good. And what caught my attention was the language that he was using. And then throughout the rest of the movie, I started to notice more and more examples of this language that was being used, of traditionalism becoming a revolutionary, jazz dying, there's not enough young people, all this stuff, and it made me think of the church. This all kind of culminates in this really heated argument that me and Seb are having, in which Sebastian says,
"Well, no one likes jazz, not even you."
Which Mia heatedly responds,
"I do like jazz now because
of
you."
And this is what I thought you...
What follows is probably my favorite quote of the entire movie.
"People will want to go to it because you're passionate about it, and people love what other people are passionate about. You're..."
So as hopefully all Catholics know, we're all universally called to mission and to holiness. We're all called to be a saint. For me, on my own path to sainthood, I've always found it really helpful to look at the lives of other saints, the ones that have gone before us, the ones that have accomplished their life goal. These saints, or revolutionaries if you will, have paved the way before us, giving us an example of how we can achieve our own goal and our own path to sainthood. I would argue the fact that anyone with faith today can probably trace their faith back to one of the saints before them. But why? What makes them so special? What did they do to end up in heaven and now recognized throughout the whole world as a saint? How did they achieve that level of holiness in which all of us can look back and trace our faith back to one of them? People love what other people are passionate about. The passion of the saints spread like a wildfire to everybody that surrounded them. And in turn, those people ended up passionate about their faith, and the fire just continued to spread up until today. But in the past couple of decades, we've seen a pretty rapid decline in Christianity and in the faith. And I think a huge part of it is because we've lost the passion for it. As Sebastian says in the movie, it's dying. And the world says, let it die. But not on my watch. Along comes Sebastian's friend, Keith. In this example, I think that Keith kind of represents, in an imperfect way, Satan and the rest of the world. He says,
"But you say you want to save jazz. How are you going to save jazz if no one's listening? Jazz is dying because of people like you. You're playing to 90-year-olds at the Lighthouse. Where are the kids? Where are the young people? You're so obsessed with Kenny Clark and Thelonious Monk. These guys were revolutionaries. How are you going to be a revolutionary if you're such a traditionalist?
How are you going to be a revolutionary? You're playing to old people at the Lighthouse, but where are all the young people? You have to get with the times," basically, is what he's saying. By the end of the movie, we can see that getting with the times leads Sebastian away from his real, true passion. However, when he goes back to pure jazz, as he puts it, we can see that the club that he begins is full of people, young and old, and they're all super excited about what he's doing there. Now, let me introduce to you Ryan Trahan, fun drink loving, socially awkward, incredibly wholesome guy. I'm part of a generation that has grown up watching YouTube videos. As a filmmaker myself, I was totally influenced by Julian Smith and Rhett and Link, and YouTube has only grown to influence me as a filmmaker. I've been watching Ryan Trahan on YouTube for about a year now, and every single time I come away from watching one of his YouTube videos, I feel just super uplifted. I can't make any judgment on Ryan's personal beliefs, whether or not he's a Christian, but I can easily say that he has a beautiful heart for the well-being and goodness of other people. And I bring him up in this video because I think he perfectly illustrates the point that I'm trying to make. Ryan Trahan is truly passionate about helping other people, whether that's traveling across America for a fundraiser to donate millions of dollars to hungry people around the world, to getting his friends a fun drink. You can see that he just really has a heart for anyone in humanity. He literally spent a whole month going from one side of America to the other with only a penny. And by the end of the series, he uses this as a means to donate millions of dollars to this charity that is going to help feed people across the world. He gathered so many people to donate to this charity along with him because of his contagious joy. He wasn't doing anything special. He wasn't telling people that they get a tax receipt and get all this money back. He was just really passionate about feeding hungry people. So why did other people donate? People love what other people are passionate about. I think what I'm trying to say is that you can make a difference. You might not be a famous jazz performer or a successful YouTuber or in the world's eyes, anyone of any importance whatsoever. But don't be afraid to pursue your passions. Don't be afraid to be who God made you to be, because you have no idea the impact that it could make on someone's life. How are you going to be revolutionary? How are you going to be a saint? How are you going to pursue your passions? And I'll leave you with this quote from St. Catherine of Siena. Be who God made you to be, and you will set the world on fire. Okay, so if you liked this style of video, it's a bit different to what I normally do. It's not a vlog, but if you liked it, please leave a comment below. If you agreed with what I was saying, let me know. If you like La La Land, I know it's a pretty controversial movie. I'd love to hear your thoughts about it. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel, and I will catch you on the flippity-flop. See ya.